Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So in today's video, I thought I would go through some Italian stereotypes and say whether they're true or not in my experience. So if you guys didn't already know, I spent like a year living in Italy on exchange. And I lived with three different host families and I went to school there. So yeah, I feel like I have a pretty good understanding of the culture. So yeah, let's just dive right into it. Alright, number one, Italians only eat pizza and pasta. This is definitely not true. There are so many more Italian foods other than pizza and pasta. But I definitely will say that they eat pizza and pasta a lot. When I was there, I pretty much had pasta every single day for lunch. Yeah, if you didn't already know, like, Italian school finishes around 1, so people normally go home for lunch or they go out for lunch, so... Yeah, lunch is a pretty big meal there, and yeah, I pretty much ate pasta most of the time, and also pizza as well. That was pretty common. For example, if teenagers was going out on a Saturday, like to a restaurant or something, they would normally always get pizza. Number two is it's really expensive. I think people have this idea that traveling in general is very expensive, especially to like places like Italy. But when you consider other places in Europe, honestly, Italy is probably one of the least expensive, besides like all of Eastern Europe. But yeah, definitely, obviously the bigger cities are going to be more expensive because there's more tourists, so the prices are gone up. But like in small towns and stuff, yeah, it's really, really cheap. Like tourism, you can get like a decent meal for like 10 euros and a coffee for like 1 euro, so yeah, it's really, really good. So it's really not expensive when you compare it to other places like London and Switzerland, and yeah. Number three, that Italy is just like Rome and Venice and all the like under the Tuscan, like the famous places, when that's really not true. Italy as a country is super diverse. Like even in my head, before I went, I had this idea that it was just gonna be like big cities. I don't know why for some reason, but that's not the case. Like there's actually so much nature in Italy. Like there's the Dolomites, the mountains, and then you've got, go to the south and you've got like all the beautiful like seaside towns and stuff. And it's, yeah, it's just really super diverse, and it is so much more than just big cities, even though that is a huge, like a great part of it. But yeah, Italy's just super diverse. Yeah, I think if you're going, definitely go to the big cities, but visit small towns as well. The next thing is that they love kissing each other, I guess. Like they, which is kind of true. Like when you meet somebody like that you've never seen before, you will often do like the two kisses on the cheeks. It's pretty common there, and even when you're just greeting people, like visiting family or whatever, yeah, it is really common to kiss people on the cheeks. I think that is just a European thing, so yeah, I don't know what to say. It's true, I guess, so get ready if you're going. You do get used to it though. Like I thought it would be like a huge thing because I thought it would just be super weird and uncomfortable, but you really get used to it. Like I did that to people in my class, like it was just really normal, you know. So next is they're really loud. I would say this is true. Italians in general, they're just very passionate. Like if they're talking about something that they really enjoy, like they will get into like heated like conversations, like you, to the point where you think they're arguing, but they're not, they're just having a conversation. So yeah, I would say that's true. Next is that the mafia is like there, and I guess, I don't know, it's just dangerous. I would say that it's false. But to be fair, I lived in the center of Italy, and I believe that the mafia is, I guess, mostly supposed to be in the south, especially near Sicily. So yeah, I didn't really experience myself, so, but I can't really speak for the whole of Italy. But in general, I think if you're going, then you don't need to worry about any like it being dangerous or anything. Yeah, it's pretty safe in general. Next is all Italians look the same. I guess people have this idea of like olive-skinned, tan, dark-haired Italian people, but that's not always the case. In fact, yeah, you get all different types of people like everywhere you go. But yeah, Italy as a country as well is very diverse, especially big cities. So yeah, just get used to there being different types of people and different types of Italians. Next is Italians are crazy drivers. I would say this is kind of true, to be honest. Basically, I think there is a speed limit, but it's not really enforced. So on the highway, people will drive like 150 kilometers an hour, which is really fast. In my opinion, like coming from New Zealand, the max is like 100 kilometers, and you don't really go over that, maybe like 110. But yeah, anyways, Italians are just like, yeah, it's pretty crazy, man. Next is that Italians love football, like soccer. I would say this is true, but to a certain extent. Yeah, pretty much all the guys I knew in my class, they did like soccer, but then again, there were also some people that didn't. So, yeah, I don't know. Football, like soccer, is definitely huge in Italy, but I would say, like everywhere, like it's not everybody's thing, you know? So, yeah. Next is that they ride scooters everywhere. This is kind of true, actually. Like in my class, a lot of kids, and in my school even, a lot of kids had scooters and bikes, and they would ride them to school every day. I think it's because in Italy you have to be 18 to drive, whereas to be a scooter, I think it's only 14. So yeah, a lot of kids do have scooters, especially like in rural places. Just because the roads are really small as well, so yeah, it makes sense to have a scooter, I guess. Yeah, so they're really common in Italy. Next is that they love coffee. This is definitely true. Every family that I stayed with in Italy had a coffee machine in their home, and like schools have vending machines that give coffee. So yeah, coffee is definitely like a religion. It's great. It's amazing. I miss it. Next, Italian families are huge. I would say this is false. Family in Italy definitely is very important, but not all families are like massive. So one of the host families that I stayed with only had one daughter, and the other had two. So yeah, like huge families. I guess the stereotype just comes from they have like lots of family gatherings, I guess, like during Christmas, Easter, that kind of thing, where everybody gets together. But yeah, I would say the modern Italian family isn't necessarily like massive. It's just like one or two, maybe three kids. Like that's pretty normal. Next is they talk with their hands. I would say this is true. Like they definitely do have like loads of hand signals. Like my cat. Like yeah, people do talk with their hands. It's a thing. Next is that they're very fashionable. Yeah, I would say that is true. I mean, Italians, like teenagers, like they'll wear sneakers and they would wear jeans, like you know, like casual outfits. But when they dress up, they really do know how to dress up. And even the guys especially, like I think, yeah, like I remember going to birthday parties, like, and you'd see like 17, 18-year-old guys in like suits, like 16, 17-year-old guys, like dressed up in a complete tux, like suit. Not like a tux, but like a suit with, you know, a tie and a jacket and everything. And so yeah, that's pretty normal. So yeah, I definitely think Italians are very fashionable, and I always felt like underdressed and like just like my clothes were not good enough. So anyways, that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Obviously most of it was my opinion, kind of based on fact and my own experiences. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next time. Ciao.